How we can create a loan file from for an existing borrower. So there's a couple of different ways to do that. The most popular way, the most common way, or the way that is most popular, is to go into your pipeline main. And let's say we wanted to duplicate this loan file here. We can click on the Quick View folder. We can duplicate the loan file. That's the most popular way, because you have the option of copying the loan file, and you have the option of copying it with or without all the uploaded required documents as well. So let's say we have this existing borrower. They want we're gonna open up a new loan file with them. We can come in here, click on the Quick View folder. And down here we have some different options, but the last one on the right is the click to copy this file button. So right now we can click on that. It's going to ask us, would you like to copy this file? And we have the option to copy the file with all the uploaded required documents or without all the uploaded required documents, or we can cancel. So let's say we wanted to copy this with all the documents, we would just click with docs. And it's duplicating the file now. And now we see it up here at the top. It says the borrower's name and the word copy right next to it. So now we can actually go into this loan file. And you can go through this file and clear out or reset certain information that is going to be related to the new loan file. You can go into the docs and see all the old uploaded documents, if there are any already uploaded. I didn't have any in here, so there aren't any, but you would be able to see those as well. And you can delete any like properly related documents if it's a different loan file. So you can just get new documents that are related to a new property, for example. So that's the most common way to do it. The other way is you can go into the actual borrower's contact. So if you go to borrower lists, and you go to that same borrower, you can just scroll all the way to the right. And you have this option right here, create a new client file for that borrower. So you just click on that button, and it will generate the loan file with the information. It's going to ask you right here, would you like to import basic information from the borrower? You can say yes. And now the new loan file is created here. But this is not as popular of a way to copy the loan file, just because it's going to bring over very limited information about this borrower. The other way allows you to bring in a lot more information, so there's less work as far as having to put in new information or anything like that. This is just an alternative route, which, it's one way to do it. It's not the most popular way to do it. Same thing, if a borrower, it's the equivalent of the borrower going to your Quick app after they're already in your system. When they're filling out the application, if they use the same email address, it's going to recognize that they're already in the system. So if you, same thing here, if you go to Quick app and you go to quick, fill out a new Quick app, and it recognizes that the user is already in the system. So let's say I come over here, go to the Quick app, and this is the same thing. This would happen whether you're in your back office Quick app or if you're on the on your public facing borrower Quick app that a borrower would fill out. If you come in here, you select your branch, and you select the loan program, let's say fix and flip, and we come in here and put in an email address that the system recognizes. Now it's going to give you the same thing. Would you like to import the basic information for this borrower? You can click yes, and then it's just going to import that information over. So for the borrower, what'll happen is if they're on the public facing Quick app or full app, and they're filling this out and it recognizes their email, they're going to get a prompt asking them if that this let them know that the system recognizes that they're already in the system, and if they would like to import some basic information in if they say yes, then the system will send them, it'll email them a one-time passcode. So they'll receive an email, they'll be able to put that code into the system, and then it will import just their basic information. So that's a couple of different ways to do it, but again, the most popular way is just to go into the pipeline and duplicate the loan file, and then just you can go in, and once you duplicate it, you can just change everything in there. All right.